Filtration of drip irrigation systems is absolutely essential, but there are two things that we deal with when we are purchasing or looking at products to install on a zone of drip irrigation or an entire system that uses drip irrigation. One is pressure regulation, obviously the other is filtration, but pressure regulation is needed to keep a match precipitation rate. If you get excessive pressures in the line, you may have some drippers that won't operate to the technical specification. So generally, each product is going to have an optimum operating pressure. So look at the technical specifications for whatever product that you're about to purchase, and then match your filter and your pressure regulation to what that particular product of drip irrigation needs. Now, when it comes to pressure regulation, you probably get, you know, somewhere between 25 PSI to 45 PSI is the range generally that you're going to find in the products. And one of the reasons that we really need pressure regulation in drip irrigations, especially goes with the style that we're going to talk about that uses a solid drip tubing that we insert drip emitters into. Now, it's just a simple hole in a tube and a little barb that we push in. So we don't want excessive pressures in this tubing, or it'll blow the emitters out. It'll blow the fittings loose. So these type of systems aren't necessarily set up for the pressure that say a polyethylene or a PVC constructed irrigation zone could withstand. I mean, I know of irrigation systems that are running at 150 PSI, but if we tried to apply that pressure to some drip tubing, it would blow the fittings apart, it would blow the emitters apart, or blow them out of the tubing, depending on the style that you use. But also the filtration part of it is absolutely essential. We know that if you're using a water from municipality, we call it just city water, is how we describe it around here, but city water has more debris in it than what you would think. We normally don't see it as the water comes into our house because we have some screen filters and some different things going on in the system between the main line out in the street and what we experience here in our house. So there are several things that can trap pebbles or dirt and stuff in there. But when it comes to drip irrigation, these little tiny particles of dirt or rock or whatever may come through will definitely clog up the emitters. So we want an adequate amount of filtration. As you're looking at these products, you'll find a couple of different ones, and we're going to talk about these different products in the next lecture, but you can get mesh screens that range in size from maybe, you know, 50 microns up to 200 microns, but there's different levels depending on the need. So be aware of that and know that if you buy a drip filter, you probably can get a replacement screen for it that has a different micron size of openings in the mesh. We'll talk about that a little bit further. But I just wanted you to know that there are a lot of options available here. And, you know, just back to the issue of stuff coming through the water lines, you know, I found pebbles as big as my thumbnail in valves, in water pipes, because there's all types of damage that happens. People trench through lines to install a telephone line or television cable or something like that. So there's lots of ways that, you know, particles or adulterants can get introduced into the irrigation system. And we definitely want a way to filter those out before it gets into the drip tubing. Now, if you're pulling from a lake or a canal or some type of body of water that may be a little bit dirty, and in fact, centrifugal pumps, you know, on the edge of a lake, they're basically pulling from the bottom of the lake. They may have a pipe that goes along the bottom and angles up a few feet off the bottom, but even still, it pulls water up and it pulls these particles up from the bottom of the lake. So in those situations, if I'm installing that type of system, what I'm going to use is maybe two layers of filtration, a large filter on the main line as the water comes out of the lake. And then once it gets out to the individual zones, I use a smaller filter to make sure we screen out the small particles from that. Wells around here are pretty popular. We, you know, in some areas of our state, we have, you know, a moderately low water table, so it's easy to use a well to pull water up from the ground. But a lot of times you get sand that comes from the bottom of these wells, whether it's just regular sand or that mica sand that looks a little shiny when it comes up. You can definitely tell that this stuff will get down in the heads or the drip emitters in this case and clog this stuff up. So we definitely want a filter or multiple filters on the system, but we also need a maintenance plan on how we're going to flush these filters and clean the screens out. It doesn't do you any good to install a filter on a system if the owner of that system or the manager of that property never cleans the filter. In fact, it can even damage some of the other parts of the system because the flow gets reduced by the buildup of particles in the filter itself. So especially with pump systems, be careful with that. So it's better to even not use a filter on non-drip systems if there's no maintenance plan or there's no chance of getting these filters cleaned out several times a year. Now, some water is dirtier than others, but it all depends on your situation. And the advice that I'm giving you is that if you're dealing with a situation to where you're using drip irrigation or any type of irrigation that uses, you know, little small orifices like spray nozzles or whatever, the filtration is going to be essential. But just make sure that you look at the products that are out on the market and choose the right one for you and set an actionable plan that can be followed for the draining or the flushing out of those drip filters and the cleaning of the mesh screens or the platelets or whatever method is used for the filtration.